Hi everyone, welcome back. Let's have a quick recap whatever we have done. We talked a lot about the Sequelize ORM, its model definitions, schema model definitions, and the types we are defining. Okay, so I'm just skipping the slides here. What Sequelize is doing is Sequelize is mapping JavaScript object to SQL tables using models. So these are the models which we are defining. So the post is a MySQL table, and in the JavaScript, this title and description is being mapped to the actual database column. So Sequelize is doing the mapping of these JavaScript objects to the MySQL tables. Okay, and these are kind of properties, title and descriptions. Those are being mapped to the post table columns. Okay, and we had talked about this connection.sync, connection.connect. All these utilities are doing nothing but they were just reading. If you just pass force true, means it will just wipe up the, it will just drop all the schema definitions has already been created, and it will create them again. Logging, it means it will use a, it will just do con, it will use a console.log, and you will be able to see all the messages on the console. Right, now other thing is the how we define the schema model, right? Like the post, the user, cart, product, whatever the model we are defining. So we need to define the types. So here we can do a lot of things while defining the schema model. So sequelize.define foo is actually the table name, and its first argument is actually the variables which you are going to have, like flag is of type boolean, allow null is false, default value is true, and you can also put alphanumeric or numeric value as a primary key as a true, so that will be treated as a primary key. Like my date, it's sequelize.date is a type, default value sequelize.now, which represents a current date. So default value automatically it will take current date, and title is of type string, and allow null is false. So these properties can be, there can be three or four properties you can put for each and every attribute, like the type, the default value, allow null true or false, the primary key true or false, index if you are adding index on top of that. So we have these types, string, integer, data, array, boolean, binary, all these are actually the types which we are using in our Sequelize, right? Now if you see the code, what we are seeing in the code is whatever you see, like the schema definition, the first schema definitions here we have. So if you see the define, what define takes as an argument, define is actually taking all the properties. This is the first argument. Then second argument is, if you see, this is the model definition. I will try to expand it. So Sequelize.define module name, I mean so the table name, or the, then here we are defining the column. Column A type is boolean, validate. So in validate, like for the email, I have done the validation, is email true here? Is email true in the validate? Similarly, here you can put the different validations. Is, I mean the value should be of, follow this regex pattern, maximum is 223. Is in, I mean the value should be a part of this enum only, message must be English or Chinese, field name is column A, right? Similarly the column B, column C and all. Now other arguments which it is accepting is the hooks, where you can add hooks in the application. So I will show you, the model will be this. Yeah, here we are doing it. So first argument is a model definition. Second argument is our hooks. I mean this is where you can put the hooks, and hook, what the hooks are, hooks are actually before validate, after validate. So whenever the validate runs, so these are actually Sequelize hooks gets added onto the schema model, which can execute like before a validate, after validate. We need to look at some documentation for it to get more understanding. So I can show you this one, hooks, right? So I defined a schema here. I defined a schema, right? So if this is the second argument, before validate, after validate. Similarly, once you created a schema model, you can use add hook method to add another hook, like before validate, after validate, before create, after create. Like before create, you wanted to decrypt the password, so you can create, you can use a before create. After create, you wanted to store or do something else, you can just use after create. So these are actually universal hooks. You just define all your properties, and in the define you can add the hooks as a second argument, and before create do stuff, before create do your own stuff, and once the user has been created, that before create will execute, right? So these are actually the different hooks we have. These are actually useful. So you can actually write your own hooks also, sequelize.beforeConnect. And before connect, what it is doing, it is just adding a password and that can be used later. So before validate, after validate, before create, after destroy, before destroy. These are actually hooks we are using in our application. Okay. Other than that, we have seen a lot. So this is actually the section 01. From section 02, we'll try to see how we can structure these different schema models. Currently, those all are written in the server.js. This is not the right way. We might have multiple models like post.js, user.js. Then how we can isolate them in a separate folders and can do the database sync using sequelize.sync.